a man of the past. He was in the mosque, and as the imam finished his prayer, he was a great scholar. The imam was a great scholar. As soon as he finished his prayer, the salat al-dhuhr, everyone he got up to pray the sunnah and everyone left. So he thought to himself, hectic, that's it, this guy, everyone's left. I'll wait for him to finish his sunnah and I'll get up and ask him some questions. I'll have him to myself. He was a great scholar. So everyone had left and he sat there waiting. He narrated this scholar prayed from dhuhr all the way to asr. He prayed all the way to asr. And then at asr he stopped. They got up, they prayed the asr. And then he goes, after the asr, inshallah, I'm going to talk to him. I'm going to ask him my questions. After asr, he opened the Quran and he read Quran till maghrib. So this man, he's standing there watching. He goes, inshallah, after maghrib, who prayed the maghrib and I'll ask him. He prayed the maghrib, he got up, he prayed the sunnah and he prayed till asha. After asha, he goes, you know what, after asha, I'll ask him. He has to get tired sometime. So after asha, inshallah, before he goes home, I'll catch him. So this man gets up after asha and he prays till fajr. He prays till fajr. 12, 13, 14 hours, depending on the time. So he got up after Fajr and he goes, inshallah, after Fajr, I'll ask him. He got up after Fajr, he made his tasbih and he got up to pray after the shuruq. And this man was standing there. He goes, I saw him get tired. And I heard him make a dua. Do you know what dua he made? He goes, oh Allah, I seek refuge in you from feeling tired and not being able to worship you properly. They understood our purpose of life. They understood that on the day of judgment, the only currency is your good deeds. The only thing that you can buy with is your good deeds. They understood that if you don't have enough good deeds on that day, you're not going to buy anything. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was the man who never could you find a good deed except he's perfected it, except he's the first one there. No matter what companions would do, yani Umar radiallahu anhu, when Abu Bakr was Khalifa, when he saw Umar, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu leave after Fajr every day and go somewhere, one day he followed him. This was the Khalifa. This man ran the affairs of over a third of the planet. That at that time Islam had reached over a third of the world, and in Umar's time it reached over two-thirds. So this man ran the entire affairs of the Muslim Ummah. Where is he going after Fajr? So he followed him. Where did he find him going? He found him enter a certain house. And a little while he left. So after he left, Umar radiallahu anhu entered. And he saw an old lady that was blind. She said, who just came in? She said, I don't know. And this man comes in every day after Fajr. He cleans the house. He cooks us food. He milks the sheep. And he leaves. He said, you don't even know who he is? She said, no. He began to cry and he said, yeah, Abu Bakr, you beat us in every field. So the next day he said, I'm going to beat Abu Bakr to do that action. So before Fajr, he went to this lady's house to do the action and he found Abu Bakr leaving already. And he said, subhanAllah, look how they understood that on the day of judgment, your good deeds and your bad deeds will be weighed. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى. He who does one single atom's weight of good, that day he will see it. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. And he who does one single atom's weight of evil, on that day he will see it.
أتذكر يوما كنت تعانق دمعة الفكر تناجي الله في صبر وترجو رحمة تسري فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت